Hello everybody, welcome to our new video. Today we're going to fix the problem which says merchant key is invalid. The supplied variable are not according to specification PayFast payment gateway. Yeah, that's a problem. If you do try to place an order, you'll get that message from PayFast, and I would say also maybe it might happen in different payment gateways, but this time we're using PayFast, and also we're using WordPress. We use their plugins. There are two plugins. There's a PayFast e-commerce. Yeah, that one's integrated in the e-commerce plugin itself. So we find that problem when we try to do some order. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna go to the website where I want to place an order. Let me say PayFast. Not PayFast. We're gonna go to the website called kingmosa.co.za. We go in there. When we in there, you can see we're gonna try to place some orders. I wanna buy this, and I click on that. Then I'm going to add to cart. After adding to cart, you can see everything I put in here. Everything I put in here already. I'm gonna change also the mail to be Trey James 71 2020@gmail.com. Put in the address. If you want a different address, you can click here, then you do those different addresses here. But anyway, the shipping address is different, it's not different, so I'll leave that. We can put a note like I will collect my order on Friday. Friday. Why is it like I'm failing to write Friday? Okay, the 27th of June. Okay. So then I'll select PayFast. Then I say place order. After placing the order, you can see we get that error, which says it says the supplied variables are not according to specification. Merchant key is invalid. And if you go here up, it says you are in sandbox. This is a testing environment. Use it to ensure correct integration with PayFast. If unexpected, please contact the merchant you are trying to pay to resolve the matter. So this simply means we did not switch off the sandbox, because if your PayFast or any payment gateway is in sandbox, it's like you are in a development environment whereby you can test, whereby no transactions gonna be made. So if you reach this page, just know that everything is fine. But it could happen that you forget to switch that off, and your clients are seeing this and they're asking you, what's going on? We cannot make payments. We see an error. They are not programmers. They wouldn't know what's going on, but they can even not read it. You see this app. Most people, they won't read it. They're gonna read something which is in red. They say, what is this? They don't understand that. So as a developer or your own website, you have to make sure all these issues are fixed. But if you look at the money, you can see the money is what is put in the rightly, everything goes, everything is fine, and also it gives us the store and also the order number, and also it gives us having trouble with the whatever, then it gives us this also. This is PayFast stuff. So you cancel this. When you cancel the order, then you click here if you automatically redirect, please. Okay, let's click. Okay, it took us back to that order. So we're not gonna do much. What we're gonna do, we're gonna go there, go to your dashboard, click your dashboard. Also, you go to WooCommerce, then you click settings. When you're in settings, you click on payment. When you in payment, you click on, you look for PayFast, you say manage, click on manage. Yes, you can see this is on. You can say PayFast sandbox, switch this off and go to the bottom and save. There's some, okay, let me see. Once you save that, I've done that. I'm gonna save on this side, this side. After saving, then I'll show you that I've saved everything. So I've saved everything. So, but now I'm gonna go out of that. Just scroll to the down to the bottom of the page, then you save. After when you have saved, you can go, you can then go back to your what your orders and click, maybe you can take another order. Here's the order. Let me see if I can, I don't know if I can delete these orders. Let me see, view cart, then we start from scratch to do a new order. But it doesn't necessarily mean you have to do a new order. I wanted to check something. Proceed with the order, edit, change address. Let me see if I can edit this order, and we see if everything's gonna work. Let me try to edit the order. It doesn't give me that chance to edit the order. Okay, it's fine, it's fine, it's fine, it's fine. Let me go back here, and we see if we can do, use this, our orders. Say filter, we don't need filter. Okay, there's some filters and there's a lot of things here. Let me see if I can add on this order here, this one. If we get that one, then we can say we can add it also to cart, add to cart. So now we go here and we say view order cart. We can view the order before we do what we do, place an order. Okay, this is the order. Okay, if we can say I want to take out this, I want to take out this, and okay, return to shop. Let me say return to shop. I want to see if I still have order. So I don't have any order, so it's fine. So I want to place a new order. I want to get maybe this, and maybe I take one of these, not two. Let me see if you're, what's going on here? It's easy. Let's go down, 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 down. Then we say add to cart. Okay, I've added that to cart. After adding, so I'm gonna go to my cart here and I say checkout. Okay, when I go to checkout, then I can then, yeah, I'm on checkout. This is my address. I can change the address and everything in here because I might get some error. Let me try to change the address. Okay, let me see if it can work. Okay, let's say proceed. I'm going to proceed. Okay, my orders are fine, everything is fine here. There's nothing else I need. I can only put the what the that what notes which can say I will fetch my order on Friday, let me right click here, Friday the 27th of June. Okay, is it gonna be 27? No, it's gonna be the 14. No, 26, not 27. 26, yes, it's not 27, it's gonna be 26, Friday 26, yes. So you're trying to notify the store when you want to fetch it, so that they don't deliver it to you. You want to maybe you stay closer, or you want to save money from delivery. So after that, what you're gonna do, you're gonna say place an order. Yes, it's working. Yeah, you can see everything's working, that error is not there. So you can select maybe if you want to say instant EFT, or you want to say Visa card. If you want to say instant EFT, you can select here, then you choose the bank. I would choose maybe Capitec Bank. Then after that, it wants you to put in the same time pin and whatever, then you log in. So once you log in, then it's okay, then you can proceed with your what. You can even go back and select another thing. If you select the card, then you're gonna put in here the card number, or you want a debit card, you can put in the what, enter your MTN or Vodacom number, then you continue. There are many options here which you can use. S code voucher, if you have the S code ShopRite voucher, whatever you wanna say, then say use that voucher, payment currently pending, to complete your transaction. Okay, that's done. Okay, order received. So order number, this is the number, this is whatever. So I guess that helped, guys. Don't forget to subscribe if you have, and you can see that the shipping address, everything's gone in well. So guys, please don't forget to subscribe. If you have any other things also to ask about, you can please comment in our comment box below. But this is the way we want to conclude our tutorial. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.